Hey Notion fans, Ben here from Notion Mastery. Today we're having a look at recurring templates, a new feature in Notion that just shipped today. So let's dive right in. So I've got a new meetings database that I've set up here on a calendar, and we can see here that I've got a couple meetings in the pipeline, one from last Saturday. It's got a date assigned to it, and let's have a look at the template that I've got. We'll see something new here. There's a little recycling looking icon here. And if I click to edit this template, we'll notice that there's a new menu at the top called Repeat. And what does that show us? So repeating templates are a template that you can set up to repeat either daily, monthly, weekly, and yearly. And there's some configuration options for each of those options within those. You'll see here that I can choose when to create the template, what time of day, and in what time zone. So if I wanted to set up a meeting, a daily sync meeting, for example, at 6 a.m., have that repeat every single day, I just make those settings and hit save, and it's set to repeat every day. And let's have a look at some of the other settings here. We've got repeat weekly. This is kind of a Google Calendar style repeating system. So I could say repeat every 2 weeks on Tuesday and Saturday. When does it start? It starts on November 5th. And when is it creating the template? At 6 a.m. Same thing with monthly and yearly. These ones are a little more simple where you're just repeating it every 2 months. Or yearly, you can say repeat every 2 years or 1 year, that kind of thing. And you just hit save to do that. So this works really nicely. It pairs really nicely well with this new feature that Notion shipped recently, which is the ability to add a date mention to a title. So you'll see that, right, I've got this in here as at today. And when I hover over that, it says that this will be the date when the template is duplicated. So when I'm using this in a normal case, clicked plus here, it's automatically injected the current date into it. And I would have to go in here and change the date and time zone format if I wanted to actually show the date. But this will be a relative date when the template is created. So you'll see I've had this running for the last couple of days. So my previous meeting was set to last Saturday, and the one from yesterday on Sunday was set to yesterday. So this is the beginning of what we might call a recurring tasks feature, but right now it's more of a recurring templates feature. We can only set it to create an instance of a template and repeat that on a day or a week. And you'll note here that the one that was created this morning for me doesn't have a date assigned to it yet. This is because right now you're not able to assign a date property with the repeating template. And this is something I think Notion will probably be doing a fast follow release for in the next, you know, weeks, months, I'm not sure. So I'm going to show you a quick little tip that I've decided to do that when a recurring event is created that needs a date, I've made a little separate view here. And my filter is really simple. It just says where the date is empty. So in the morning, my template gets created. It's created it with the actual timestamp here. It's using the template. I can just click in here and I'll assign that date. And so now it's moved out of the schedule me and into my calendar. So you can have a sort of partially repeating template that creates your template in advance. Maybe it sets up the meeting template for you. And then when you're ready to have your meeting, you can come in and actually schedule that event on the calendar. And like I said, I think that templates being applied at create time and being able to assign a property. So we would expect that when the template is created, that it would actually assign that date as well. So that would be a really exciting feature to have. One of the other caveats to be aware of is that the at mention dates in the title property right now, they can't be changed to set the formatting. So basically they're always relative. So, you know, within an actual template, I can come in here and say set the full date. So that would actually show meeting on November 7th. Whereas right now in the templates, it's not possible to set that format. When you click, it just says that little hover with date when duplicated. So that's another feature that we're hoping to see in the next couple weeks, where you'll be able to change the format. So when your dates are created on a recurring basis, you would have that nicely formatted date in the way that you want it. So yeah, the fast follow feature that we're hoping to see is the ability to assign a date property when the template is created. That will give us the recurring task system that we've been asking for a long time in comparison to this recurring templates feature. So we're really excited to see that come to fruition, because Obviously, recurring templates has been a very, very, very highly requested feature. So let me know in the comments below what you're going to use this feature for. Personally, for me, I'm excited to build a recurring task system when that date properties thing is available. And I think this will be great for our recurring sync meetings, which we do every Monday and Friday within our company. It saves our operations lead a lot of time in terms of setting up those meetings in advance. And those will be just created for us when we're ready to do the meeting on Mondays and Fridays. Pretty excited about this. Comment below. Let me know what you think.